GCSE Physics Boosters, Pressure in Fluids. That's what this video is about. Now, on the surface of the Earth, the pressure acting on you is because of the Earth's atmosphere. You've got about 100 kilometers of atmosphere, air, above your head. Now, if you go diving underwater, the pressure on you is a lot bigger. And that's because you will also have a lot of water above your head, squishing you. So you're under pressure. Okay, the pressure at the bottom of this dam is very big. So the dam has to be very strong to hold it back. Okay, the concrete of the dam is much, much thicker at the bottom of the dam, because as you go deeper and deeper, the pressure of the water gets bigger and bigger. The dam has to be very strong. Okay, now a couple of things about pressure. Pressure in a fluid acts in all directions equally at the same depths. So if you look at this diver, the pressure is acting in all directions, squashing the diver. And it always acts at right angles to any surface in the fluid. So at any point on the diver, you'll see that the arrow is acting at right angles. It's acting, we say it's acting normally. A normal is a perpendicular. It's acting at right angles to any surface. And then the other important thing about pressure is that it increases with depth. The deeper you go, the more water there is above, so the pressure gets bigger and bigger. And also the pressure depends on the density of the fluid. The heavier the fluid is, then the bigger the pressure will be. So pressure depends on depth and it depends on the density of the fluid. There are a couple of equations that you need to know. The first one, pressure equals force over area. Now you could measure pressure in newtons per meter squared, but we're going to measure it in Pascal. And one Pascal is the same as a newton per meter squared. So pressure in Pascal is force in newtons divided by area in meter squared. Here's a little example. This beer barrel holds 25 kilograms of delicious beer. And its bottom has an area of 0.13 meters squared. Calculate the pressure on the bottom of the barrel due to the beer. And we'll take little g as 10. You're always given a value of little g. So pressure is force over area. The answer is P is F over A. So the pressure is the weight of the beer, 25 times 10 divided by the area, is 1,923 Pascal, or 1.923 kilopascal. The pressure at the bottom of a column of fluid of height h is given by this equation. So this is the second equation. Now, you don't need to learn this one. You do need to learn pressure is force over area. This will be on your formula sheet. It's P equals H rho G. Now H is the height or the depth of the water. Rho is the density of the water in kilograms per meter cubed. And we know what little g is by now, newtons per kilogram. On Earth, it's usually 10 or 9.8. So here's an example. This diver is 25 meters underwater. Calculate the pressure due to the water at this depth, and you'll be given the density of water as 1,000 kilograms per meter cubed, and little g is 10 newtons per kilogram. So work it out for yourself. The answer is, so P equals H times rho times G. So 25 meters times 1,000 times 10 is 250,000 Pascal, or 250 kilopascal, or 2.5, approximately 2.5 atmospheres. Look at this football. Now, this football is underwater. Maybe I'm holding it underwater because it doesn't want to be underwater, this football. Now, if you look at the pressure, look at the arrows acting on the football. Imagine holding a football underwater. The pressure acting on the bottom of the ball is bigger than on the top of the ball. Why? Well, as we said on the last slide, because the depth of the water is greater at the bottom and the pressure depends on the depth, so the pressure of the water will be bigger at the bottom of the ball than at the top. Because of this pressure difference, there will be a force acting upwards on the ball. And this force is called, you should know what this is called, it's called upthrust. Another name for it is it's a buoyancy force, but on our specification, we're going to call it upthrust. So if an object is underwater, there's a force acting upwards on it, and it's called upthrust, and it's due to the difference in pressure between the top and the bottom of the object. Now, if the weight of the ball is greater than the upthrust, then the ball will sink. If its weight is less than the upthrust, then the ball will float. And the weight of the ball will depend on its... Now, well, it'll depend on the mass of the ball. It'll also depend on the volume of the ball. It'll depend on its density. Consider this slide here. If an object is less dense than water, then it will float. If an object is more dense than water, then it will sink. And this fishy in the middle, well, its density is the same as water. It can actually control its density. It's got a clever thing in it called a swim bladder. It can control its density if it wants to go up or down. But less dense than water, an object will float on water. More dense than water, it will sink. Here's a question. This is quite a tricky question, this one. See how you do on this. This container, you've got a container ship. Now, when the container ship is empty, the bottom of its hull is 5 meters below the waterline. When it's full, then the bottom of the hull is 8 meters below the waterline. So firstly, calculate the water pressure at each of those depths. If the hull has a flat bottom of area 700 meters squared, calculate the upthrust on the ship at each depth. And then lastly, calculate the weight of the cargo. So see if you can have a go at that, pen, paper, calculator, and I'll show you the answer in 3, 2, 1. Here we go. So to calculate the pressure, P is H rho G, and at 5 meters, it's 50,000 Pascal. At 8 meters, it's 80,000 Pascal. To calculate the force, the upthrust, I've done forces pressure times area. So pressure is force over area. I've rearranged it. And so there's like 35 million newtons at 5 meters, 56 million newtons at 8 meters. And then the weight of the cargo will be equal to the difference between them. It'll be 21 million newtons. So there's 2,100,000 kilograms of cargo.